my name is Kelly May. I'm from America Global Center. Welcome to this Key Stage 2 yoga session. We're going to start straight away. So you can cross your legs, you're going to stretch your arms out to the sides, and then bring your hands together. So you know, the aim of yoga is to get our bodies and our minds working really well together. There's not like a disconnection between what our bodies are doing and what our minds are doing. So there's an integration. So start by lifting your chest. So you're not leaving your elbows on your knees. Lifting your chest, lifting the top of your head, and then close your eyes. And we're going to chant on 3 times. So you can join in. If you prefer to just sit quietly, that's fine. But I really want you to feel like your eyes are looking inside of you rather than outside. Close your eyes and feel that your eyes are looking in towards your chest. So breathe in. Deep breath. Warming up. So you're going to start, you can always stay in your own place and you don't have to move around the room. So you can still respect social distancing. And first of all, what you can do is you're just going to take a little jog on the spot like this. And then you're going to lift your knees up really high. And then you're going to take your feet behind you. And then you're going to take your feet to the side. And in front, and behind, and to the side, and once more in front, high as you can with the knees, and behind, and to the side. Good, and then feet apart, move in, lift the arms, and breathe out. And breathe in, and breathe out. Now if you see from the side, you can stay looking in front, and move from the side so you can see. Breathe in, and then as you breathe out, down, but your legs stay straight. Okay, so now I'm going to do that 6 times quickly. So breathe in up, breathe out down. And then continue like that with your breath. In to take your arms up, out to take the hands down. But keep the legs perpendicular to the floor and straight up. Maybe 6 times. And then finally release. Good. So we're going to do now a couple of poses where we're balancing. First of all, we're just going to stand straight. Okay, so that means feet together, legs together, arms down. This is the mountain pose. So you're going to have the feet really firmly rooted into the floor, like the bottom of the mountain. Your arms are going to be the slopes, the sloping sides of the mountain, and your top, your head is the top of the mountain. So lift the head without lifting the shoulders. Shoulders stay down with the arms, with the sides of the mountain. Head lifts up, let the summit. Mind your head so high it's got snow on it. Okay, now we can go for the tree pose. So you're going to balance on one leg. That means this leg turns out, and you're balancing on this left leg. And then hold your ankle and push your foot into your leg. Now see if you can lift your arms. Your arms are going to be the branches. And turn your arms, lift your arms all the way up, higher and higher and higher, up towards the sun, with those branches, and then bring the arms down. So I'm sure lots of you know this, but if you don't, it's a really good trick to know that if you keep your eyes fixed on one point, when you're standing on one leg, it really helps you to balance. So choose a spot that you can see in front of you. Fix your eyes on that, and then turn this left leg out, put the left foot on the right leg, stretch your arms sideways, so these are like your leaves, okay, your hands are like your leaves, turn up, you know how plants turn to face the sun, so this is the leaves and the branches reaching up, all the way up, and then the arms down, and release. Good. So now we're going to do some jumping again. Well, we did that before, we did some jumping. So we're going to fold the arms, bend the knees, and jump the feet apart. Okay. And then jump the feet back together. So we're going to do that three more times. So we're going to fold the arms, bend the knees. So this is like a volcano erupting. So just throw your arms and your legs out. And we go together. And erupt. And we go together. And fold your arms. And good. Now, stay like that. You're going to turn this left foot in and this right leg out. And see if this leg is turning outside. Lift your arm and then come down. And up. And down. So this is called the triangle pose. Can you see the big triangle you're making with your legs? And there's another little triangle. And you bring your hand down. You're going to turn to the other side now. So you turn that leg out. And go to the left. Can you see the other triangle? Here. One, two, three sides. And then the two legs on the floor make another triangle. So up. And again down. And up. And again down. And up. And jump the feet together. Good. Okay. So we're going to do another jump. Big jump. Fold your arms and leap. Can you keep your chest lifting up? Then turn. Right leg out. Breathe in. And bend that right leg. Now we're going to go all the way over with that hand. Top arm comes over. You're making a long line on that left side of your body. And come up. Keep the front leg bent. And over. And up. And over. And come all the way up. And feet. Can you keep your arms up? It's tiring for the arms, isn't it? My arms are tired. Bend the left leg and over. Then it feels like a relief to take your hand down. And up. And over. And up. And over. All the way up and stretch your leg. Take a few breaths, just relax. Good. So, I'm going to show you now three warrior poses. There are three warriors in yoga. So, warriors go out to fight, right? But we have to decide what we think is worth fighting for. So, I want you to think of something that you really believe strongly in, that you really think should happen in the world. And that's what you're going to be fighting for with these warriors, okay? So it might be something to do with the environment, might be something to do with peace, or learning, any of your school values, basically, okay? So, again, we're going to jump. Hold your arms and jump. So keep that, whatever it is, that thing in your mind that you think is worth fighting for, then you're going to lift your arms up. And you're going to turn your left foot and then your right leg out. And turn both your hips over that right leg. And then breathe in and breathe out, bend your front leg. Keep your back leg really straight. Bend your front leg, lift the chest and look up. And then come up. You're going to turn the other way. Breathe in. So this is like your spear lifting up into the sky. And then you bend your leg. Then you bend your leg. So front leg bent. Back leg straight, look up. And then come up. Turn your feet. Turn your feet together. Second warrior. So you can either stay with your same aim, your same value, whether that's friendship, perseverance, hope, any of those things you think is worth making a stand for, or you can choose a different one. Okay, but have one in your mind, and then you're going to see if you can stretch your legs and your arms right to the edges of your body. Even beyond. Imagine the inside of yourself is going beyond the edges of your body. And you're going to turn the legs again. Breathe in and breathe out, bend your leg. So I like thinking about this as thinking of this as like a, you can go up and down a few times with that leg. This is like your horse. And this arm is like holding a sword. So there you go. Taking your body forwards. And you can come up. And turn to the other side. Breathe in. And there you go. You can go up and down a few times. So down. Try to keep your knee over your ankle. And you're really going forwards with that body now. So have it in your heart. Take it forwards. And then come up. And okay, now this is my favourite one, third one. Okay, third one. So again, you can stick with the same value, or you can choose another thing to take forwards. Put it in your heart. So this time I'm going to choose food. So, warrior flag. Bend the knees. Tuck the feet apart. So it starts like the first one, actually. You lift your arms up, then you're going to turn your feet and your legs, then you're going to bend your front leg, but then you're going to come forward and you're going to take off with that value, you're going to fly. So the back leg lifts off the floor and your arms come forward and you're flying forward. And you land, back down, and you change sides. Breathe in, and then breathe out, bend the front leg, stretch the arms forward, you're going to turn that back leg so you can take off. Take your heart forwards, take your body forwards, balance on that one leg, well done, and come up. Wow, what amazing warriors, very, very good. So now you're going to just have your hands on your hips. Take your feet wide apart, your feet are going to stay facing forwards now. Breathe in, lift up the chest, look up, and then breathe out, move forwards and take your hands down. So you can do like this, if you want to try and take your head down as well, you can do that. Doesn't matter if the head reaches the floor or not, try and keep your legs straight. Legs straight, head down. And relax the head. Relax the head. Pull up the legs and relax the head. And then come up. So now we're going to do downward dog. We're nearly finished now, so we're going to once more stretch out the hands, the arms and the legs this way. You start on all fours, press the hands, lift the knees off the floor, and then you're taking your hips and your bottom really high up in the air. You take your legs back, and then again relax your head down and do it. Straight arms, straight legs. You can do a couple of times, two or three times. Get tired, come down, and then do again. Good. And then rest down. This is the child pose. So you can be yourself and just relax the head to the floor. You can stretch the arms forwards, then you can also rest the elbows. So it's a very restful pose. You feel the support of the floor underneath your head. Relax your eyes. And then walk your hands towards you, and you're going to lie down on your back, and bend your knees towards you like this. So this is like a little magical stone, okay? So imagine you've picked up one of those beautiful pebbles you sometimes see by the river or by the beach or in the forest. And it's really smooth. Going to be a magic pebble, so those wishes that you're holding in your heart, those values, those wishes are going to be contained in this smooth stone. And then take the feet, to the floor and stretch out the legs and just relax your whole body. So stretch your legs, stretch your arms out a little to the side, not all the way out. halfway between your arms and your legs and your shoulders. And close your eyes. Now imagine there's like a heavy blanket on top of your, something heavy on the top of your body, so your body rests back. And allow your body to rest back to the floor. And take a deep breath in. And then breathe out. And let go completely. And then once more, breathe in. Deep breath in through your nose. Imagine your toes are all little noses. So you can breathe in through your toes, right up to the top of your head. And then breathe out. And again, long, slow, deep breath in. And breathe out. So you can, in your own time, bend your knees and turn over onto your right hand side and sit up. It's quite nice to finish it with that, so you can cross your legs, bring your arms, be really tall, breathe in. And breathe out, and just your hands down. So thank you, I'm Jenny. You can find some videos quickly on our YouTube channel soon. And welcome back to school, all of you.